Hey guys, we're out in here in the Westminster Glen neighborhood, which is in Austin. It is near Steiner Ranch and River Place, if anybody knows where that is. You can kind of see everything over there, and I can't zoom in because it's the action cam, so it's about as close as you're going to get. Really nice neighborhood, but I'm going to do a carpet repair here. I did a bunch of stretching here last year, and then about a year later, he's getting ready to sell the house and remove something and finds there's some furniture stains here on the carpet. So what I'm going to do is patch a piece of this in here, and the odds are that this piece is going to be different in color because the room itself, if you'll notice, it's got all these windows here, and you're going to have sun fade on the carpet here. So the carpet on the floor will be a shade or two whiter than the carpet that I've got here, and it won't be that noticeable to anybody but myself and the guy that I'm doing the work for. Somebody coming through the house to look at it, to buy the house, to tour it or whatever, is likely to not notice it because they didn't see me make the repair. That's the beauty of the carpet repair. If a lot of times if you didn't see it happen, you don't know that your carpet's been repaired and it's completely hidden, which is what you're looking for in a carpet repair. Kind of anonymous. Don't know what happened. Alright, I can't get the right angle on this, but I'm going to cut the camera off and start cutting. I'm going to judge the grain and direction of the carpet first, and then I'll cut it. So I'll check back shortly. Alright, so what I've done here is I've taken the carpet, I cut all the edges perfectly. Now what I'm going to do, I've nailed it to the floor so it doesn't move while I cut around it. That's it. I don't want it to move because having an accurate cut can make your job a little bit more difficult than it has to be. Switch the blade around to a fresh spot on the razor and make two more cuts. So then I can lift the piece out. This is the perfect situation to show how heavy furniture indents carpet. If you can tell, it crushes the fibers here and it pushes through the backing. I'm not going to cut it anymore, but if I could, I could show how much it's pressed through. And that, you can actually see it pressed in to the pad too. So the pad has got a divot in it. So you've got a divot in the carpet, you've compressed and crushed the fibers, you've pushed the carpet backing through into the pad, and the pad is actually flat right here. And you got a pad here. So all that being shown and said, this is why it's a dumb idea to put ice cubes on carpet to try to fix a carpet indention. It doesn't even work in theory. So that's just something to know. I've heard that so many times in my life, and it even sounded dumb before I started doing carpet. I'm still hearing it to this day. Under it. Actually, I've got to plug my irons in too and get them ready, so I'm going to cut the camera here for a minute and get everything ready to go and show the seaming process. So I'll cut the camera for a minute. Alright, here we are here. Got it set up and ready to be heated in the place. Let's try to find a place to put my camera. Maybe there. Sort of. Maybe kinda. Not bad. Try this. That's not bad. Right. Oh. Alright, this is kind of a slow process from here on out because the carpet's pretty thick. So I'm going to cut the camera off for a minute and turn it back on intermittently when I'm moving the irons. save a little time on the video, keep it less than an hour. A little bit different in the color. A little bit. Point something out here. What you're looking at here is you're seeing that there's slack in the carpet now. You see there's a little bit of slack there. This is not fitting quite tight like you would like it. Reason why is not because it was cut wrong. Reason why this is happening is because me putting the iron over here on this crease that was what the same as this one right here. So you see how deep this was? Take a good look at that. Oh, that was right here too. Me putting the iron on it has relaxed it and flattened it out, which in turn made the carpet a little bit longer. So it's differently sized now due to the fact that this wrinkle or divot kind of flattened out a little bit during the heating with the irons. It relaxed it, so it made the carpet a little bit off size. Not enough to be a problem, but I just wanted to point that out to anybody that, you know, that might have been curious about that. Should finish up just fine. I'll get it tuned in over here and heat it up a couple more times. And if worst comes to worst, and it just looked terrible, you could always undo it behind me over here and kick it over the wall if need to be. But I feel like it'll be okay. Just a little bit off in color. Nobody would ever notice. Somebody would look at it and go, something's different, but I can't tell what the hell's going on. I don't know what's going on. Alright guys, I'll check back in a few here. I'll probably wait till I'm completely finished with it all. I'm going to heat kind of around it from different places to try to tweak it and make it look like I want it to look. So I'll check back in when I'm done. Alright guys, we're done. This finishes up my Friday. I think I got one job tomorrow, and that's it for Saturday. So in case something else books, there's gonna be one job tomorrow, and then I get like something like a weekend. That's different. All right, here we're all done. Just a little bit of difference in color, and it actually it's looks like it's a little more noticeable on the camera than it is in person. But that shows you the difference that you get when carpet's installed. It changes colors so slowly due to the sunlight coming in that you don't notice. That's really all there is to look at this one here. The gentleman asked if taking a piece out of the closet would be closer, and it wouldn't, because if you go to the closet, you go over there, and by the time you turn the corner, you're back in an area where there's no sunlight's been either, so it should be the same color as this here, because it changes color so gradually on the way to the closet that you don't notice. All right, guys, that concludes this episode of Carpet TV. Appreciate you watching. Please like, subscribe, and share. That's all appreciated. God bless. If you have questions, you're always welcome to text 512-350-1129. Corey Thibodeau with Carpet Muscle in Austin, Texas.